The library is an open space. It's a place where kids come in the morning. They rush the doors and come in here to eat their breakfast or use the computers to play video games with each other. There's a lot of different types of students. There are readers who come into the space. There are people who are not readers who come into the space, just because the library is the heart of the school.
I think being a middle school librarian is extremely difficult, and especially here in Nashville, because our middle school's grades 5 through 8. So when you're thinking about building a collection and how to serve students, that's a really large range of programming.
Kids want to be in a place where not only they feel welcome, but they see things that remind them of who they are and their culture. I believe every student needs to have places in the building where they feel safe, and it's very clear that the library serves that purpose for many of our students. For example, during Ramadan, a lot of our students who are fasting during the school day, instead of those students having to sit in the cafeteria and see students who are eating, they're able to come to the library.
Tons of different things that we think about in terms of what makes true diversity, because it's not just race or ethnicity. It's also abilities, it's also orientation, it's also religion and faith, or the lack of.
I just really like it because Ms. Long is very accepting of what people like to read, and next month is Pride Month and she already has books on display for it.
They say, hey, you know what made me feel welcome in this library? That sign, that made me feel welcome. And I knew that I could come in here because nobody else has that in the building.
We've done a couple projects, like specifically partnering with Ms. Long this year. One was that we read the book Pride, the novel. That was a remix of the classic Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen. And she approached me because she had a connection with the author, Evie Zoboy. And had a possibility of her visiting us at school, which I jumped all over.
So I went to her and said, hey, I have a proposal for you. I'm sure you're gonna say yes, but would you like to do an author visit and do a novel study? And she was like, heck yeah.
And then when Ms. Zoboy came, it was amazing to just watch the kids listen to her and ask her questions. And I was so proud of them. I think it's just important to give students the space to love reading. I feel like a lot of times in schools, especially urban schools, especially in districts that have been labeled as struggling, we tend to tell kids what reading is instead of listening to what reading is for them.
Erika is just such a powerful voice for student inclusion across, you know, all the different things that we're talking about in libraries right now. And she's just such a powerful voice for us to think about things differently, and really pushes us as a profession to be critical and reflective of ourselves and the choices that we're making. And I think we couldn't ask for a better librarian here in Nashville.
Thurgood Marshall Middle School is an amazing place. And I know even in particular, our librarian has such great relationships with some students. She may be the only adult in the building that some of these students have, that they feel that they can talk to her. It is making a tremendous difference in our school.
That's one of the things I'm grateful for about our library, is that it's just really free, that you can go in there and you can love whatever book you want to love, and there's not judgment about what book you're reading. There's no requirements.
When it comes to relationship building and making the library work, it's important to create, build, develop, sustain those relationships with students as well as faculty. Coming into a school library for the first year can be challenging. It can cause a lot of anxiety, especially when you're not from this place. And so it's very essential to take small steps where you can see them.